All right, we've got another update on the Mega Hall. I have moved into the room I'm kind of using to stage it all. Another load of stuff. So we're going to go take a look at what that stuff is here. This is mostly going to be Lego stuff. There is still more after this, but it is getting lower after that. So here we go. We've got a General Grievous Combat Speeder, 75199. I have two more. The Anakin's Pod Racer. So we've got quite a stack of those at this point. Pirate Ship 31109. That's a good set. A Razor Crest down below that. 75292. Another good set. And then below that, another UCS. It's the Tantive IV. Actually, this is technically not a UCS. I think that's the case. Yeah, it's a little widgy in my memory. But it was a good set nonetheless. Yeah, there's no plaque that goes with it, so that's all right though. That's still a good set to have. Here's a bag. We've got Thwomp Drop, Mario 71376. Two of that. I like the fact that I'm getting quantities of the same thing. That's always helpful. The Rebel A-Wing Starfighter, 75247. That's a good little set. And get rid of this bag. Yep, just toss it aside. That's not a problem. Here's another bag. We've got 3-in-1 Modular Sweet Surprises, 31077. And I'm thinking we probably have three of these right here. Two. Three. Bag. Got a box here with stuff in it. Let's get some of this stuff out here. Ugh. Oh, okay. Han Solo's Land Speeder, 75209. That's a cool set. I like the hounds. Corellian hounds. Those are kind of cool. Ah, another AT-ST, 75254. That's a good set to have. Ugh. What do we have here? Now, this one's open. Let's see what we got in here. It looks like it's probably sealed, so it's probably, the pieces are new. Whether or not it's completely complete, don't know right off. But this is the 75233 Droid Gunship. So that's not a bad thing. I see a Lego Movie 2 set. The Battle Ready Batman and Metal Beard, 70836. Ugh, here's another one of these we saw last time. Yoda's Hutt. 75208. That's a good little set. A Batman set. 76117. Batman Mech versus Poison Ivy Mech. That's considered a mech for Poison Ivy. It's like, okay. All right. I consider that kind of a lame mech. That's like an animated plant. Which makes sense for her, but I don't think I would have called it a mech. Anyway, you got one of those, and it looks like, yep, a second one. So we have two of the, not a mech, really, and we've also got the Flash. Somebody named Firefly in there, too. I don't think I'm familiar with Firefly. I know Flash. I liked him as a character. All right. I guess I still do like him as a character. All right. 75201 First Order AT-ST. That's cute. Got a BB-8 in there. Poe. No. Finn and Rose and Captain Phasma. Alright. Probably a couple of good figures in there. Ugh, what's this one? First Order Heavy Scout Walker. 75177. That's kind of a nice little set. Who do we have in this one? Resistance Trooper, First Order Gunner, General Hux, and a First Order Flamethrower. I don't even recognize the General Hux, so yeah. Probably somebody that was in the movie and wasn't actually named or was not important enough. And then look, yep, you guessed it, another copy. That's, we got duplicates of that. Reach over for one more, and yep, it's a third one. So we got three of that. One item left in this box. It's a big one though. Ugh. It's the bookshop. 10270. Very happy to get this. It was on my list to get additional copies of, so here it is, already set. So that's going to be a good thing. Now we can get rid of this box. I'm just kind of making a mess over here. I just make the mess now. I'll clean it up later. Here's a Walmart box. What do we got in here? Okay, this is a bag of some loose stuff. Now this is, there was also some loose Lego in this haul. And that's what this is. These are items that he purchased at Goodwill or other thrift stores. I mean, this one's pretty old. You've got these old wheel elements here with the bricks, or they click in there. This is probably not Lego, this bicycle thing here. But yeah, this is just a lot of old brick. Look, a Playmobil person. Special police. So there's some non-Lego in with this stuff. I did see this earlier too. Instruction book for set 2152. I don't know what it's called, but that's the instruction book for it. That was kind of interesting. Another loose bag here of Lego, I'm hoping. I mean, I have seen a few non-Lego pieces here and there. So there's going to be some of that here. But here's a city set and one or two instruction books. 60026. It's two instruction books, whatever it is. And again, whether or not it's a complete set, don't know. But there's that. There's another bag of some random parts. Okay, there's a bag that has nothing in it. This thing here is probably not Lego. Doesn't look it to me. A lot of times at the thrift stores, they'll just throw in whatever they got. And, oh, look, it's a few random little pieces. Just throw it in the bag and sell it. Here's a piece that just became loose from something. It does say Lego on the pieces there, so there we go. I'm just going to toss that back in because we're going to put this stuff back in this bag when we're done. Another bag of just really basic pieces. And look, an old Fisher-Price dude in a cowboy hat. He might even have some value all by himself. Who knows? We'll check it. We will check it. Looks like an Etch-a-Sketch that maybe had some other stuff in it. Maybe that other stuff was Lego. But there you go. I mean, it's, you know, you kind of get what you get when you buy an entire storage unit, or in this case, too. Here's a battery cover for something. Now, this might seem odd, but I will probably keep this. I think I have somewhere a small container with a bunch of battery covers in it, because, well, if you ever get one that matches something that you need a battery cover for, bonus. And they don't take up a lot of space. Here's another one. There's a Duplo guy in there. I see him rattle on. That's actually the Joker, I think. A Duplo Joker. Yeah, pretty sure that's what that is. That's pretty cool. All sorts of other little pieces in there. The front of a police plane or a helicopter, perhaps. That obviously is not all in there, just not enough pieces scale-wise. There's some minifigure there. So there's some minifigures in here, too. That's pretty cool. What else do we have in here? Another little bag with some random pieces in it. An instruction book, 60026. Oh, this is the same. I think that's the same instruction book for the other set, because this is book two, so maybe there's three books to that. I don't know. Put that aside. We'll figure it out at some point. Another bag of the really older Lego. And you can almost kind of just tell. I think there are some slight color differences. But here, you know, you don't have the side supports on the tubes underneath. So it's an older piece. That's a long plate there. A blue plate there. That probably has some value. I don't know. I mean, it obviously has some value, but well, we have a Happy Meal toy, it looks like. Although maybe not. This might be one of the other companies. Kubo. Cub. Kubo. It's Burger King. Ah, there we go. Burger King toy right there. So we'll have to look that up. I used to sell these on Amazon. I have a whole bunch of them. That I will be digging out once I start unpacking or even moving here, the Amazon inventory. And at some point, we'll probably go back to selling that stuff on eBay. I don't think Amazon is going back to anytime soon. And there's a rescue piece. It looks like there's more pieces in the bottom of the bag there. This is probably not Lego. Some Happy Meal toy, probably. Some guy in a little jet car or whatever. McDonald's. Yep. Okay. So That might have some value. I will, you know, look it up at some point. Not right now. This is not that point. So now we're just going to load this stuff back into this bag. There is some more loose that I have here at the moment, and there's more that'll be in another video going forward. You know, at some point, I think I will dump all these various looses into one container. I'm not sure how I'm going to deal with processing the loose for this purchase, because I would like to keep track of how well I'm doing for the purchase. So I might try to deal with the loose all at once from this purchase and at least get an idea of how much I've listed it for, so that I know. Oh, look, there was a screwdriver on the bottom of that bag. And then at least I'll know at that point how much it was initially worth. All right, so now we're going to look at a couple items that are non-Lego. This stuff was also in the storage units. I have a World of Warcraft poster collection. It says it's 32 removable posters. Somebody that was giving me a hand is familiar with this, actually. And apparently it's actually only 16 posters. They're all two-sided. So you can't actually hang all 32 unless you bought two copies of this, which you could feasibly do. And then a very similar item for DC Comics, the new 52 poster collection, except for this one is 40 posters, probably the same thing. There's 20 double-sided posters. So that's kind of a cool thing to have gotten. And then the last thing right here that's non-Lego is a metal Batman sign poster thing. So it's got that metallic sound to it. So that's kind of a cool item. I actually know somebody who likes Batman stuff, so maybe they'll end up getting it. We'll see. But in any case, that was the non-Lego from this purchase. I'm going to put that aside. All right, so now we've got some Lego bags. These were some that were as they were and some that I basically threw stuff in a bag because there was a bag there and it was convenient to carry. So we're just going to pull this one over and take a look. 31079 Sunshine Surfer Van. I kind of like this set. I like the old the micro bus kind of idea. So that's kind of a cool set. And why look, as is tradition, we have another one. It really works out for my purposes. You know, parting out this stuff, getting multiple copies of the same sets, it's just going to make this whole purchase so much easier. Another People Pack Funfair 60234. That might be the same one I had from before. I don't recall offhand. It'll all get organized together at some point. More Mario. This one is Mario's House and Yoshi. 71367. And I don't see a second copy of that right off, but I just see another Mario set. This is another one of those Thwomp drops. The 71376. So we'll have another one of those. That's up to three on that one at least. I got a bag here. What is in the bag? I don't know. It's a little space set. It is the satellite service mission, the city space stuff, 60224. I had this already. I actually collected this line, so I have them all. But now I've got another one of this, and I might have additional ones, so I'm going to add it to a part-out party. Another, what do we got here? Oh, another Sunshine Surfer Van. Well, that's always a bonus. Now we're up to three on that one at least. Another Mario down here. What do we got here? King Boo and the Haunted Yard. Well, ain't that something? 71377. So another one of those Mario sets. I never bought any of them for myself, for me. I have to admit, I never played any of the Mario games, so there's no special place in my heart for them. I mean, I understand that they're important. I understand that they're groundbreaking might be a little bit of a stretch, but I mean, they were very popular and they were all over the place. And I kind of have a general idea of how you would play, but I don't think I've ever played, or if I have, it's like one or two times. And then another one of that King Boo set. So again, always nice to have duplicates of the same sort of thing. I'll put that bag over there. Pull over another bag and start looking at this stuff. Another First Order AT-ST. That's always good. So we're up to a couple on that one at least. Another People Pack. This one is Outdoor Adventures. 60202. I like this one. I like the little raft and the tent piece is always kind of cool. You see these in some of the friend sets and other sets like that, and those are neat. Kind of, I think it harkens back to the sails on the pirate stuff. Oh, and we got another People Pack Outdoor Adventures. That's cool. What do we got here? Ah, General Grievous's Combat Speeder. I think we started the video off today with one of those. So there's another one of those. General Grievous and his three lightsabers, and Mace Windu with his one. Let's see what else we have here. Trouble on Tatooine. That's a relatively new set. So, I mean, he was buying stuff. And this is a 2021 set. He was buying stuff pretty close there. It's only been a couple of months since this has been out. So I have a couple of those, I think. So we'll add that to the pile. Another droid gunship. I think this is the one that was open, if I remember correctly. So here's one that's still sealed. So which is good because I'd be able to open a sealed one and look at the unsealed one and see if it is actually complete. Does it have all the bags? Was there any large loose pieces that weren't bagged? Because they do that sometimes. You know, you have a set like this. Here's another one. Perhaps these curved sections aren't actually in a bag. They might just be loose in the box. Or they do that with a base plate or just a larger plate that's maybe not a base plate, but they'll do that. And they'll have one or two pieces that are floating around in the box loose. Or a big tire or something like that. I've seen all that. Action Battle Endor Assault. I thought these were kind of odd. I mean, I kind of get what they were doing. It's more interactive, there's motion, but I'm not sure I see it as being super fun, but I could be wrong. It's just me. All right, what do we have here? Ah, we have the Outback Cabin 31098. That's kind of cool. It's got the brick built eagle and the brick built wolf, or maybe it's a dog. I'm not sure. Those are kind of cool. So you're not just going with the figure ones because they did make a figure of an eagle. I kind of like the antlers over the doorway too. That's cute. So that's a nice little set. Another small one down here. Oh, we got another one of the Action Battle Endor Assaults. And then there's one big one in here. Yeah. And that is the Crocodile Locomotive 10277. Well, that's kind of a cool set to have. 1200 plus pieces, still sealed. That's always a bonus. Toss that bag over there. Now we're gonna pull this bag closer. This is a pretty full bag. Let's see what we have in here. I see Lego Movie 2 at the top. And this is the Emmett's Triple Decker Couch Mech. Now, I have to say, I've always thought this was a cool idea, this triple decker couch thing. And I guess you can build the actual just couch version of it down here if you decide. But yeah, I kind of thought that was a cute thing. Maybe I'm easily amused. Did you guys like that? Did anybody like that? Another People Pack, Fun at the Beach, 60153. Another cool set. Got the sail piece for the I guess a surfboard kind of idea. It's not exactly a surfboard, sailboard, I think they call those. So that's kind of cool. Another copy of the General Grievous's Combat Speeder. The sticker I just pulled off of it because it was stuck up a little bit, not flush to the box. Good to have another one of those. Yet another People Pack, another Outdoor Adventures. I just also noticed it's got a small baby. That's kind of cool. I like those little tiny baby pieces, especially since it's got a minifigure head, but it's smaller than a normal minifigure head. I think that's kind of cool. What do we got here? It looks like another Lego Movie 2 set. Ah, it's another couch mech. So there you go. And a couple of bigger sets. I have Rex's Rexplorer 70835.